Okay, there was another option called minimum percent good that allowed you to specify there's a certain minimum that has to be met in order to actually show the results of actual percentage of good data. So let's take a look at that. I'll go ahead and open up a new area. We're going to go ahead and look at the tag CDT158. I'll go back to the last 15 days to the current time, and we'll specify a, in this case, a one-day interval, and I'll require a 100% of good data in order to display the results. So I'll choose calculated data. Remember, I'm going to be using the advanced option of minimum percent good. That's what we're looking for here. So my tag, start time, and end time are all as you would expect. The time interval is going to be 1 day. Oh, let's call this a totalization. And we'll specify the percent good as a cell reference to right there. And when I go ahead and click on OK, what we're seeing here is that for certain of these values or dates, we are not getting enough good data. Now, there's a couple ways I could make this a little bit easier to read. First of all, I can put the timestamps, and secondly, I can actually show the percentage of good data. So I'll go back into here. I'll specify that we want to show, let's show the start time, and I want to show the percentage of good data. So now, having done that, we can see exactly which of the dates here have insufficient good data. Yeah, this particular day is missing a little bit of data, and this is missing a little data as well. So that's the option called minimum percent good. Well, the last of these new advanced options is called event sampling. Event sampling is an option for how we treat any expressions that we encounter, either as filter expressions, like the one we're going to use here, or as the expression that determines the calculation itself. It controls how we decide to interpret that expression as far as sampling goes. So, for example, when we have a filter expression like this, what values are we going to assign for sinusoid and CDEP158 when we do that filtering? Are we going to assign evenly spaced values? Is that how we're going to be filtering this or sampling this, these two inputs? Or are we, for example, going to look at the timestamps when there are values in the tag whose values we're actually retrieving? Are we going to use that as the basis for the sampling? Let's go ahead and actually do this as a retrieval. I'll go ahead and delete what we've got here. I'm going to be doing an advanced calculation in which, you know, that's our tag. Here's our start time and end time. And this time I'm going to choose a filter expression. We're only going to be looking at the values in CDT158 when sinusoid is greater than 80 and CDEP158 is greater than 210. And we're going to look at an average. That's what we're interested in. Now, this option called expression sampling defaults to something called point compressed. And what that means is we are going to look at each of the timestamps from when there was a value for the tag that we're retrieving or that we're calculating this on. So CDT158 has, there are certain timestamps for archive values for that tag. Well, it's those timestamps we're going to be using when we determine the values that we will use with these filter expressions. Let me demonstrate. I'll go ahead and choose OK. Yeah, with that option, I got a result of 151.745. So now we're going to explain what's happening in just a second, but just look at the difference. If I choose for my advanced option, instead of point compressed, if I were to choose expression compressed, I actually get a different result. This is now at 149. What was the difference? Well, let's take a look. When you use point compressed, what we're going to do for that filter expression is we're going to be looking at all of the timestamps of the tag whose value we are calculating right now. Let's say we have an example here in which we simply want to do a calculation of this tag CDT158. We want to filter that calculation, whether it's a total or an average or what have you, doesn't matter. We want to filter that based on the behavior of these two tags, the blue and the yellow one here. What we're saying is when the two of them added together is greater than 30, well, that's when we want to do the totalization or the average or the calculation. So if these are less than 30, if when added together they are less than 30, those are the values we want to ignore. Well, how do we determine how often we look at those actual filtering values? Well, what we do is we look at the values as they come into the source tag. The timestamps of those values are what we use. So we evaluate these filter tags at that timestamp. At this timestamp, it's 75. Add those two together, it's 75. At this timestamp, which is the next archive value, it's 75 again. At this value, however, as you can see, at this point in time, which is the next archive value for the source tag, it's at 17.21. So as this crosses here, that's the period of time. That starts the area that we're going to filter. We're going to go ahead and filter anything in which we do not go over 30. And we're using this timestamp here to determine when we do the calculation. There we go. So the end result here is, we end up doing the calculation only when the two of them together are over 30, and we do that calculation, we determine whether it's over 30 at the timestamps of the actual source tags. Yeah, that source tag right there in green. Now compare that to expression sampling using not point compressed, but using expression compressed. That's another one of the options. With expression compressed, now what we do is we do that same calculation, is it greater than 30, but we do it every time one of the filter tags has a new value. So these values that we see in the archive, those are the values that determine for us how often we do the sampling. Now there's a third way, and the third way is to just do straight interpolations. You're asked to provide a timestamp or a time interval, like for example 10 minutes, that's the default, and we just kind of time slice through this, and that's what we end up with as the times where we evaluate the filter expression. So let's look back here, and just again, we saw earlier that when we change this, the values are actually going to change on us. When we change that sampling method, or the expression sampling, we get different results. If we were to choose interpolated, then we need to specify this interval. It defaults to 10 minutes, and that will give us a third result. So you can see that's different than the other two. Now this expression sampling is something that affects any expression. So not just filter expressions, but also, if you're actually doing a calculation that is itself involving an expression syntax. So if we were to take a look at, let's take a look at calculated data, where we're using two different expression sampling methods, you'll notice that there is a difference between the two. So if I go into calculated data for this expression, that's my expression right there. We use start time and end time. Okay. I'm going to omit the filter expression at this point. And let's go ahead and use a time interval. I think I'd like to use an average in this case. And under advanced, I'm going to choose the expression sampling called compressed. That's the default. Now with this syntax, when you're not using a filter, in this instance, you're only going to be presented with two, either compressed or interpolated. With compressed, I'll go ahead and show the start times here. And we get this set of results. Now if I were to, instead of actually doing the calculation at each compressed event, I were to do some kind of a time slice at 10 minute intervals, I'm going to get slightly different results. And let me demonstrate. I'm just going to go ahead and copy this. I'll do a paste special over here and just paste the values so that we can see the difference between the two. Let's make sure we have the right number of decimal places. There we go. So that they look the same. Now the reason I did that, I copied this over here, just the values, is so we can compare before and after. Watch what happens when I change this. Instead of using this compressed, let's use Interpolated now. So what we're going to be doing here is we're going to be doing that calculation every, we're looking at the calculation at 10-minute intervals, okay, instead of just based on what's in the archive. At 10-minute intervals, notice they're not very different at all, slightly different, you know, based on the fact that we're now slicing through that data, doing the calculation at a different interval of time. An interesting way of demonstrating exactly what's going on internally is to switch from a calculation of average to a calculation of count. Count is going to count the number of times the calculation's actually been done. So if I switch over to count, and I make a couple of more changes here, and let me switch this over to make this event-weighted. Event-weighted means we're going to see the number of times the calculation has been done. And I'll switch this to compressed. So in this event, it should show me the number of times, the number of compressed events we see for, you know, total for these two tags during that 1 hour period. We click on OK, and we see that there's a fair amount of variation here. What it's telling me is that from 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock, there were 12 values for CDT158 and sinusoid combined. From 8 to 9, there were 11, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Now watch what happens when I change that. Instead of using compressed, let's use interpolated. And with interpolated, I'm going to choose this 10-minute interval. Remember, this is going to show me the count, the number of times it was calculated. Look at that, 6. Well, what is 6? Well, it's 1 hour divided by 10 minutes. If I were to change this to, instead of 10 minutes, you know, change this to 5 minutes, at 5 minutes, now we're going to get a number of 12. It indicates the calculation is being done 12 times now. The definitive word on all of this you'll find in the online help. So take a look at the expression sampling mode. You'll find documented both for filtering expressions and also for calculations.